Hello and welcome to the second round of races of the Sim Racing Online Touring Car Championship Season 1. Tonight we're at Birmingham Motorplex on one of the shorter layouts. And we come off the back of round 1 last Thursday, in which we saw Andreas Eriksson take a clean sweep of the first two races with pole positions in both, and Matt Farrow took the win in the third race with the reverse top 10. And there is a few drivers now just finishing off qualifying. The clock is on zero, so a last ditch effort for drivers to try and sneak pole. At the moment Farrow is on pole. I'm not quite sure where Mr. Eriksson is. Let's take a look at the list, and it looks like he is down in 8th place, so something has happened to Mr. Eriksson. He hasn't got a decent lap in, and he is 8th overall. So currently on provisional pole is Farrow, second is Jeffrey Ruskus, third place is Jordan Weeks, who's a newcomer to the series, not a newcomer to SRO, of course takes part in the Kart Factor Championship, fast driver there. In 4th place at the moment is Gary Lennon. 5th place is Nielsen, who is in the pit, so he won't improve on his time. 6th place is Shelley Stenbeck. 7th place is Mahmud Patel, who's still out. Let's see if he can move up anywhere. It looks like we've gone into warm-up, so he won't get another chance. So it'll be a 3-minute warm-up, and then we will go to the grid. It'll be a standing start. No formation lap. We have about 17 drivers today, so a pretty good turnout. They're normally very fun, these races, only 15 minutes long, full of action. Obviously three races on the night. First two have qualifying, the third one is a reverse top 10. So I will just give the drivers a quick race briefing now, so bear with me. Okay, so that is the race briefing done. Just over a minute and 30 to go before we go to the grid, so you can take a look at the grid. I was telling you before, was provisional, so Matt Farrow does take pole, Jeffrey Ruskus second, Jordan Weeks third, Gary Lennon is fourth, Anders Nielsen is fifth, Shelley Stenbeck is sixth, Mahmud Patel in 7th, Andreas Eriksson 8th, Wayne Reed in 9th, good performance from him there, Mark Foley 10th, Dave Simmons is in 11th, Sergio Sousa is 12th, Mario Moraes is 13th, Bradley Anion is 14th, Jonathan Motteram is 15th, Floria Callan is 16th, and starting from the back is Mr. Sobolewski, who has a penalty which didn't allow him to qualify. That was from the previous race. I believe we are just waiting for one more driver to get back in. That is Mr. Brook, who's got 40 seconds to go. Let me see if I can restart the warm-up for him. Bear with me. Thank you. Okay, so we will go live in a couple of minutes. Made a bit of a mistake. I tried to use the Stream PC to log in as the administrator, but failed, so everyone now sees the password, so that will need to be changed on our server. So apologies about that. I am trying to multitask at the moment and run an admin the race whilst doing the broadcast by myself, so apologies for that. And it looks like Mr. Brook has made it in. So, any second now, we will go to the race. There we see the qualifying times. And any second now, we should get the lights. There we are, the lights come on. It looks like Farrow gets a good start. The man in third place there gets a little bit loose. Who was that? I believe it's Gary Lennon, who's gone up to third, putting Ruskus under some pressure. It looks like Farrow has got off to a great start there, held on to the lead. Second place is Ruskus. Looks like everyone's made it through okay. No spinners as they come up through the first right-hander. So, perfect start for Farrow, just what he wants. Looks like he's either the fastest or the second fastest man on the server. His main competitor, Ericsson, is way down the order due to some sort of mistake in qualifying. But will he be able to pull away? He's really got the gap up to nearly 0.4 of a second. Gary Lennon up to third. I believe that was Andreas Ericsson is up to fourth. So great start for Ericsson. He's going to look to try and get past Gary Lennon as soon as he can and push on and try and catch Farrow. This place is Jordan Weeks. I think he went backwards at the start. Poor start from Weeks. Sixth place is Scheller Stenbach. He's got past Nilsson, who is a bit down. Wayne Reed from 10th place got up to 7th. It's a great start to him. I think he's being attacked by Anders Nilsson, who has dropped back at the start. Who's sat there going by side, and looks like Nilsson's got the job done on Wayne Reed. Nilsson up to 7th. As Wayne looks at making a pass there, thinks better of it, and almost loses the car as it steps out under braking. Great shots here at Birmingham Motorplex. Got some really high speed cambered chicanes. A real challenge for a lot of the drivers. A really, really rewarding circuit, in my opinion. It looks like that's Nilsson now. Come onto the back of Stenbeck, two Swedish friends. And Nilsson will be trying to get past as soon as possible. I think he is the quicker out of these two. It's Mats Farris as the fastest lap of the race. Look at that for a lead already. A decent gap back to second place man, Mr. Ruskus, who now has Gary Lennon all over the back of him. I'm expecting Mr. Ericsson, who is in fourth, to catch on to the back of these two very quickly. Looks like they're taking different lines through that corner. It's right on board with Mr. Lennon. It's a really tough corner, that one. As you come up the hill, the car does get airborne. You need to set the car up perfectly for the immediate right-hander after. You don't want to be running out wide. You want to get on the power as soon as you can. Obviously, this isn't the full circuit, so that's where they cut off some of the larger circuit with that. It looks like Lennon was so close under braking there up to the back of Ruskus. Meanwhile, back in 10th is Mr. Foley. He'll be looking to push on a bit from there. His normal pace is faster than that. Farrow again sets the fast lap of the race. And looks like Wayne Reed has lost another position there as he moves back to 9th, the 8th place man. Off Mohammed Patel has got past him. Obviously a expect Mamet to be way further up the pack than this. FSR driver claims to be a professional sim racing driver, but struggling a bit today. Back in 11th, we've got Sergio Sousa of Atlantic Racing Team. I felt that someone spinning back there. Who is that? Looks like Richard Sobolewski is. Let's see if we can get a replay of that. I see what happened there as we fast forward. Let's see what happened there. So he comes up the hill and loses the back end. Hits the wall. Someone in front of him is also spinning. Not quite sure who that was. If we can get a... No, we're riding on board Tim Brook. So it was Tim Brook and Richard Sobolewski that both had some issues there. We get back up to the action, and I believe that was Mr. Brook going off again. Obviously he hasn't done any practice for this. The first time he's driven the car. And it certainly does look like it, as he was cutting the grass a bit out wide. Meanwhile, back at the front, Mr. Farrell leads. 10 minutes to go, so we've had 5 minutes of this 15-minute race. Fairly hefty gap. We look back there, the second place man. Jeffrey Ruskus still under increasing pressure from Gary Lennon. They've also got Ericsson hot on their tail. The fifth place man isn't being dropped either. So Jordan Weeks is staying with them, so I think we're going to have a four-way battle here for second place. That looked like Stenbeck in the background, also having some fun with Mr. Nilsson. We look back here, Nilsson looks at the inside. Definitely some contact made there as Nilsson's car went through the back of the camera there. And a love lost between these two good mates off the track, but obviously driving like enemies on it today, as Matt Farrow setting back-to-back fastest laps again at 104.6. That's very fast. Obviously wanting to catch Ericsson back up in the championship, where the points are distributed, and this doesn't actually mean that winning gets you a decent lead. So I think the gap is only 2 or 3 points in the championship, even though Ericsson won 2 races. So Farrow doing what needs to be done here today, whilst Ericsson is in fourth spot. I was expecting Ericsson to be hot on the tail of second and third, but it's still a few tenths behind, and it looks like Ruskus is dealing with the pressure quite well, because he hasn't made any mistakes yet. So Gary Lennon hasn't had any opportunities to make the pass. Now obviously Gary's a very, very experienced driver, lots of touring car races under his belt, so I'm sure he'll have something up his sleeve. With 8 minutes to go, so you need to get the passes done quickly in these races, as you run out of time. Can't afford to sit there for laps, choosing a spot. If there's a spot, you got to go for it. Looks like Ruskus has run a little bit wide there. He should get good exit speed. They want to be going side by side up through this corner. Awesome shot there as we see the cars heading a little bit loose as they go up the hill. Looks like Lennon is thinking about going up the inside there, but not close enough. So he will have to wait for another opportunity. So it does look like we're going to have a four-way battle here, five-way battle here for second place, as I believe. No, it will be a four-way battle, as Stenbeck and Nilsson are getting dropped a bit. So far, Nilsson's still not able to find a way through. It's massively sideways there. Further back down in 8th spot is Mohammed Patel. Looks like Wayne Reid fighting for his life in 9th spot. And who's that going down the inside? That's Foley in the Leighton House themed Toyota, I believe. So Foley working hard. Looks like he's got a good run at the last corner. Looks like he's going to try and go around the outside as Wayne's going defensive. Brakes a bit later. Wayne goes in deep, luckily. Mark didn't try to go around the outside, otherwise he would have been straight on the grass with the speed that Reid carried through the corner. I'm expecting Mark, it shouldn't take him too long. He's a very, very fast driver. I don't think he's practiced too much for this one today, otherwise he'd be much further up. But Wayne so far driving a good race. He's higher up than where he started. So Eleventh place is Dave Simmons. He is got Sobolewski behind him at the moment. 13th place is Bradley Vanian. 14th is Sergio Sousa. 15th is Jonathan Motteram. 16th is Mario Moraes. And 17th is Mr. Brook. And, oh, so 18th is Floria Callan, I believe. So back to the front, Farah leads. Bit of a walk in the park there at the moment as we look back from his car. Under no real pressure. Should be an easy 5 minutes. Didn't need to push too hard, so good to wrap this one up. This will be back-to-back wins from him, of course, winning race 3 at the first round, Alton Park. Second place is still Mr. Ruskus, starting to get a bit of a train behind him, but they're not close enough to make a pass. It's quite a difficult track to make a pass here because of the awkwardness of the elevation changes and the cambered corners make it quite difficult. Obviously being the same spec, same power, not really much you can do with these cars. Though very much evenly matched, that's why they normally make for great racing, is you don't need to spend hours making a setup in these. It looks like Gary's taking a better line there. He's going to have to try and go around the outside unless Ruskus goes deep. No, Ruskus holds the inside. So that could be one opportunity, but it's a long, long corner to try and go around the outside. Difficult place to make it work. And it looks like someone just got a little bit loose there. It was Jordan Weeks as he went up the hill. Let's see if we can get a replay of that. Yeah, I think this is where we saw Tim Brooke and Richard. Yeah, manages to hold on to it, so only lost a bit of time there, but that won't help him with only 4 minutes 25 to go. So it's just going to be a three-way battle for second place at the moment. You see the running order there, so Wayne Reid has moved up to 8th, so something has happened to Bully, who is now down to 10th. It looks like Patel and Foley have made a mistake. It looks like Mohamed went back and Foley tried to follow him. Wayne Reid is attacking Patel. Contact made there. That looked a bit unnecessary. Let's see if we can get a replay of that. Be right on board with Wayne Reid. Looks like he's waiting, so here we are in car with Reid. So Patel goes down the inside. Foley's thinking of it too. Bit of contact there. Really any space to pass here. And yeah, definitely avoidable contact there. And Foley, the real winner of that one, as Foley has now got up to 8th place, I believe. So Patel obviously losing a lot of time there. It looks like Stenbeck has been passed by Nielsen, but not being dropped, so we missed that during the other battling, because Stenbeck is all over the back of Nielsen. Jump back to the battle for second place. Ruskus still in second, but there's been a change for third, as Andreas Eriksson is now in third. Let's see if we can get a replay of that pass. It looks like they're close, and Gary Lennon there, so this is 30 seconds ago, so we've missed that pass by Eriksson on Lennon. And it looks like Eriksson is not going to be happy to settle for third place. They've got some traffic there. Quite sure who that is. Looks like that was Floria Callan getting out of the way. Eriksson, don't think he's going to be close enough to go up the inside here. Really difficult one as well, because as we saw earlier, this is the corner where the cars get a little bit airborne as they cut out the middle sector of the full course here. Weeks, while these guys have been battling, has managed to catch back up, so he'll be looking to attack Lennon for fourth spot. Barrow still leads, 2 minutes to go. Under no pressure whatsoever. Second place, still Ruskus. Third is Eriksson. Will he have a go down in turn one? Looks like they've got a similar exit onto the straight. Not too much being offered up as a slipstream. Look at that for a huge lead. Farrow leads by over 5 seconds. See what Eriksson sees as they head up, definitely catching a bit, but Ruskus gets a better exit there. Looks like Eriksson had a bit more grip but couldn't really set up the exit, so he's not going to get the opportunity here. There should be one more lap after this one. Looks like it takes a very, very tight line. A lot of curb there. Really unsettles the car. Closes up on the braking. Once again, Ruska's power down that bit sooner. Obviously being the lead car. Battle for 7th. Looks like Nielsen has dropped Stenberg, so maybe there was a mistake there from Stenberg, as that gap has now increased by quite a bit. Meanwhile, back to the battle for 2nd, which has been held pretty much by the whole race by Ruskus. 45 seconds to go. This will be the last lap. And Jordan Week on the last lap, 104.6, snatches the fastest lap of the race. I can't remember off the top of my head if there is a point for fastest lap there. There might be a fastest lap point, so definitely worth trying to push hard, as he's done well to catch back up to this pack after a mistake, as it looks like Ericsson has dropped off Ruskus a bit, and now that's allowed Gary Lennon to attack. So it's gone from attacking to defensive work here from Ericsson, but obviously it can all change with one poor exit from the man in front of him, Ruskus, and it looks like Ericsson's caught him a bit as we watch Farrow head towards the final few corners. Like it will be a last minute dash to the line as Ruskus makes a mistake with two corners to go, and it looks like Farrow's going to cross the line for the win. Second place. It looks like Ruskus has got back down the inside. It's going to be side by side to the line. I think Ruskus is going to get it. Gary Lennon going for the inside. It looks like he's going to pull it off. And I think he did. That was very much a photo finish. I think Gary Lennon may as well have got second. Ruskus third. I don't think Andreas Ericsson had the momentum. He may have dropped down to fourth. Let's see if we can get the standings up for you. And yeah, Gary Lennon grabs second place. And Ruskus in third. So Ruskus lost it to Ericsson. Then got it back from Ericsson. Them two were dicing through the final corner. And it went back to Lennon. So, crazy finish here at Birmingham Motorplex, as we see someone going straight on as they finish the race. Donuts there. So let's see if we can get the finishing order up for you and confirm it. Matt Farrow, dominant win, just didn't get the fastest lap, as I think Weeks got it at the end. So Gary Lennon, awesome driving there to get up to second on the final lap. Crazy finish. Ruskus in third. Look at the difference in the time when they cross the line between those guys. Ericsson in fourth, Jordan Weeks fifth, Anders Nielsen, good recovery, to sixth, Shelle Stenbeck seventh, Mark Foley up to eighth, Sobolewski in ninth, Ahmed Patel is in tenth, Wayne Reed is 11th, and Dave Simmons in 12th, Jonathan Motoram is in 13th, Sergio Sousa 14th, Bradley Binion is in 15th, 16th was Tim Brook, 17th Mario Moraes, Floria Callan was 18th. So that ends race 1. We will be back in about 5 minutes for race 2.